Today I want to show you our project. Our team is consists of Somalia Rami, Muhammad Hassan, Amr Ayman, and Khalid Walid. Our project is consists of a three-phase high power inverter that will drive our three-phase induction motor for our electric vehicle company. This project is evaluated under the guidance of Professor Vishwas, and now we are going to show you the power. This is the car, and now I will show you where we put the motor and the controller. Here we will put the motor, and the controller will be placed at the back seat here because it is a large one, so we need more space.
First of all, we use ETVega 2560 Arduino because it has a large number of pins and also a large flash memory to store our motor. Secondly, we use three timers, timer 3, 4, and 5. Each timer is for that a single phase. The timers are using a phase for that TWM model. This is used to compare between the sinus and sine wave to get an output as PWM, and this is used for our main version. Then we add a code for the dead time to check that and to make sure that the signal is not overlapping each other. Lastly, we use we can adjust the frequency in the code, so we get a suitable frequency you need for any motor. In our case, the frequency is 50 Hz.
This is the connection we have here. This is our IGBT and the SPNS for our gate drive, and this is the motor for lower screen we are using for testing, and this is the bus bar for our connection. This is the potentiometer we have for the control.
We are using semicron IGBT as it's the IGBT used in high power. Here is the connection for the IGBT. Each IGBT contains four signals from the gate drive. And this is the gate drive circuit. It consists of six TLBs. The TLB's function is optocouplers used to isolate the microcontroller board from the IGBT. And we are using six TLBs for each IGBT. One for the non-inverted. The non-inverted one is for the upper IGBT. And the inverted one is for the lower IGBT. This is the heat sink. It's made of pure aluminium, as perfect in heat transfer. And this is our encoder. We use it to know the motor RPM. And this is the connections diagram for it.
Then we connected the SMPS of the gate drive to the power supply, and now we are supplying the IGBT from a DC power supply, 220 volt, to supply the motor. And now we are going to show you how the potentiometer, the open loop control, works. This potentiometer is used to increase the voltage gradually. The motor that starts to rotate, and I'm increasing the voltage now using the potentiometer. We use this tape so it can make the rotation more clear. Now the motor increasing its speed. The motor for speed. We use the 10 turn of the consumer, and this is the full speed of this motor.
Finally, we use fuzzy closed loop control because VIMPID controls having overshoot making its dynamic response very bad. So we will use fuzzy closed loop to get better dynamic response for our system. finally, I want to thank Mr. Bebek and Mr. Bishwas for helping us in our project.